Okay, students, let us go on to the second part of the lecture on Ethernet. Yes, so let us first see the changes in the standard Ethernet. The 10 Mbps standard Ethernet has gone through several changes before moving to the higher data rates. These changes actually opened a road to the evolution of the Ethernet to become compatible with the other high data rate LANs. So let us see this particular changes. The first one is sharing of bandwidth. Here you can see if two different stations wants to send bits onto the LAN, then the total bandwidth available is 10 Mbps. So here you can see that these two stations or two hosts have to share the bandwidth. That is, at the time when the first station is sending data, then at that time the second station will not send anything, because being a bus, only one station out of all will be able to send the data. So effectively what happen if we say that the bandwidth is now divided between the two stations who want to send the data, then the first station gets 5 Mbps average bandwidth and the second station also gets the average of 5 Mbps. Though the effective bandwidth of the Ethernet cable is 10 Mbps, but each of the station it gets 5 Mbps. Now here, if we introduce a bridge between this particular Ethernet, then these stations will be divided into two sections. So this is one LAN with six stations and another LAN with the six stations. So the original LAN, which was of 12 station, now is divided into the two different LANs of or two different sections of the LAN with six stations in each of the section. So what happens is that these particular devices will get 10 Mbps. This particular section will get the data rate of 10 Mbps and this section gets the data rate of 10 Mbps as long as the data is not to be sent from any of the hosts from this section to the other section. So the bandwidth is effectively utilized. That means the station which is in this particular section will get 10 Mbps data rate, and the station which is in this section will also at the same time will get 10 Mbps data rate. So this is true, of course, as long as the data is not sent from one section to the other section. So the bridge improves, or bridge is going to improve the bandwidth, or you can say the bandwidth is shared. So here in this case you can see that the bridge can be used for the another purpose, that is the collision domains in the unbridged network and the bridged network is shown with this particular diagram. So if we go on dividing this particular stations into the smaller domains, so here four sections are there and this particular bridge has got four ports, and to each of the port these sections they are connected. Now there won't be any collisions, or the collisions will be reduced, because on this particular section of LAN only three stations are there, whereas here 12 stations are there, and out of these 12 stations, if any two stations are trying to send its data on the bus, then collision occurs. So the probability of the collisions without bridge is more than that of the LAN with the bridge. So the significant reduction in the collision is achieved by using bridging. Then the next one is that you can go for a switched Ethernet, so that the highest version of reducing the number of stations in a section will be that only one station will be there at each of the port. So here ideally you can see that there won't be any collision, because in each of the section there is only one station. So by using the switched Ethernet we can see that we can reduce the, or we can eliminate rather, the collisions. So actually there is no bus, that means we have removed the concept of bus here, and here the stations they are connected to each other through a switch, and this becomes the star topology. Then the next one is the full duplex switched Ethernet, so in which you have a separate line for the transmission and the reception, so that the communication will be fast between this particular station and the switch. In the earlier case the communication was half duplex, that is when switch is sending some data to the station, then at that time the station has to remain silent, or when station is sending any data towards the switch, then the switch has to remain silent. But whereas in this case the link between the switch and the station is such that simultaneously when the station is sending something, it can receive data from the switch. So this particular communication is the full duplex switched Ethernet. So earlier it was the half duplex switch Ethernet. Now let us move on to the next version of the Ethernet, and that is the fast Ethernet. In this we shall see the MAC layer protocols and the physical layer protocol, or what are the changes at the MAC layer and the physical layer as we move on to the fast Ethernet from the standard Ethernet. The fast Ethernet was designed to compete with LAN protocols such as FDDI or the fiber channel. The IEEE created fast Ethernet under the name 802.11.1 3U. Fast Ethernet is backward compatible with the standard Ethernet, but it can transmit data 10 times faster at the rate of 100 Mbps. Okay, so you can see the major change from the standard Ethernet to the fast Ethernet is that the speed at which the data is transferred or it is sent or received is 100 Mbps. The goals of the fast Ethernet can be summarized as follows. It is the, of course, the first goal is upgrade the data rate to 100 Mbps. It is compatible with the standard Ethernet, and then it has kept the same 48-bit address, then keep the same rate, it keeps the same frame format. The frame format for the fast Ethernet is same as that of the standard Ethernet, and it keeps the minimum and maximum frame length. So the whatever minimum and maximum frame length is there with the standard Ethernet, so that also is applicable to the fast Ethernet. So you can see that the major change here is the change in the data rate from 10 Mbps to 100 Mbps. The topology for the fast Ethernet can be like this. It can be a point-to-point topology, or it can be a star topology. So the stations may be connected to the switch in this fashion. The common implementations for the fast Ethernet can be with 100 base TX. So the two wire strategy, which uses the category 5 UTP cable. The second implementation can be the 100 base FX. So it is two wire and it uses fiber optics. Whereas the third implementation can be 100 base T4, and it uses the four wires, and the type of wire used is the category or CAT3 UTP cable. So this is the encoding for the fast Ethernet implementation in all the three implementations. So here the encoder is used, which is 4B/5B encoder, whereas the encoding is done with the MLT3 encoder in this case. So like this, the original 4 × 45 Mbps data gets converted to 125 megabits per second, and that is the final data rate here. So the appropriately in the other two also the encoding is done, whereas at this particular 100 base T4 only 4B/5B encoder is used. Then to summarize all this, you can go through this particular table for the purpose of the three different implementations of the fast Ethernet. The next one is the gigabit Ethernet, the need for even higher data rate resulted in the design of this gigabit Ethernet protocol, which works at 1000 Mbps, or in the other way written 1 Gbps. The IEEE committee calls the standard as 802.3z. The goals of the gigabit internet design can be summarized as follows. The first goal was to upgrade the data rate to 1 Gbps, and it was make it compatible with the standard or the fast Ethernet. It uses the same 48-bit address, it uses same frame format, and keep the same minimum and maximum frame lengths, and to support the auto negotiation as defined in the fast Ethernet. So in the full duplex mode gigabit Ethernet, there is no collision. The maximum length of the cable is determined by the signal attenuation in the cable. So here are some of the topologies that are used in the gigabit Ethernet. So you can have only two stations connect, and you can connect them through you can connect them together, or there is no need of switch here. In the start, you can use a start topology, a single switch and a number of stations connected to each. Then two star topology, in which you can use more than one switch, and to each of the switch the stations may be connected and the switches may be connected to each other themselves. And then there can be a hierarchy of stars. So the switches, they can be connected to each other such that they are in the hierarchy as shown in this particular figure. So the gigabit implementation has got this four different forms: 1000 base SX, of course this 1000 stands for the speed, 1000 Mbps. It is two wire, and it uses short wave fiber for its implementation. The next implementation is 1000 base LX. It also uses two wires, and it uses the long wave fiber in its implementation. The third is 100 base CX. So it uses two wire, and the material used, the cable used, is the copper shielded twisted pair cable, that is STP. Whereas the last implementation is 1000 base T, and it uses four wire, and it uses the UTP cable for its implementation. This is the encoding in the gigabit Ethernet. So basically, when you are using for this particular technique, it uses the 8B / 10B block encoder followed by the NRZ line encoder, whereas in the 1000 base T, it uses this 4DPAMS encoder. This is the summary of the gigabit Ethernet implementation, which is going to tell the difference between the implementations, various implementations. And finally, the last one is the 10 gigabit internet Ethernet implementation. So of course, in this implementation, the speed is 10 gigabits per second, and the topologies for the 10 gigabit Ethernet implementations, they are similar to that of the gigabit Ethernet implementation. So this particular table gives the summary of the 10G base S implementation, 10G base L implementation, and 10G base E implementation. You can see here that the maximum length of the wires or the distance between the stations, it can be 100 meters in the first case, or it can be 10 kilometer in the second case, and it can be 40 kilometers, up to 40 kilometers in the 10G base E. So particularly this one is used, or rather these two are used in MAN and WAN, that is metropolitan area network and wide area network. The media that is used is the optical fiber cable. In the first case it is short wave, whereas in the second case it is long wave. Here it is extended, and its score is 815 nanometer in the first case. In the second case it is 1310 nanometer, and in the next case it is 1550 mm, whereas the type of fiber, it is multimode, and in the remaining two it is single mode. So here is the summary of the connecting devices, and rather the different types of LANs that we have discussed in this particular lecture, starting with the IEEE standards for the Ethernet, through the standard LAN, then the changes in the standard LAN, then we discussed the fast Ethernet, gigabit Ethernet, and then the 10 gigabit Ethernet. You can find this material here. Thank you, and see you in the next lecture. Thank you.